And we're back for another episode. In this episode, we're going to be carrying on the patch 3.2 story by doing the anti-tower, one of the new dungeons added in patch 3.2. I've never done it before, I've never seen a video, I've got no idea what the tactics are. It's going to be a blind run, but it should be fairly straightforward. I'm sure at this point, the people have been doing this for like a week. Say first for me. Also, hello, if you know who I am. Sorry. Am I getting carried away with my fame? Okay, so let's do it. All my key bindings are still there. Cool. So let's hope years of muscle memory are completely in the wrong stance. There we go. Nice. Yeah. It's just, well, they've changed like all the symbols. Interesting. What have I, like, how long have I been away? Damn it. I provoked the wrong one. You've been taunted by a big idiot. Okay, that's first trash done. That's pretty, this place. Weeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee Cool. Oh crap. So I just, maybe I'm not the best tank, but I like to just spam overpower at the start. I mean, actually use cooldowns. Wow, it's been so long. And I've been playing like Blade and Soul so much lately, like this 2 seconds global cooldown feels like an absolute lifetime. But whatever, each game has got their own style, you know? That's just, that's life, that's how it is. I'm sure I got over it. The graphics are obviously prettier in this game than they are in Blade and Soul. The music is better, the story is better, but the combat in Blade and Soul is a hell of a lot more fun. So the game, will each game has its own appeal. Like, I wouldn't say one is better than the other, not by any means. Okay, just wait for the whole group to get here. Rip. Okay. I mean, rip. Bits. Rip. Bit. Oh, okay. I'm so lame. I just lost 1,000 subscribers, damn it. And I apologize if the quality of my tanking makes some people rage. Maybe there's some people who are like, oh my god, he didn't press that button exactly when he should have. And it's like, yeah, just remember, I've barely played the game in the last few months because there was nothing to do. And also as well, a few months ago when I did play, I wasn't that good of a tank anyways. So I'm remembering how to be a bad tank, so I apologize in advance. I'm here for the story. Okay, let's do this. Let's overpower some more. I just feel, when it comes to MMOs and stuff, as long as I don't die, as long as all the mobs are on me, that are, should be on me, then I'm doing my job. That's how I feel about MMOs. Maybe it's lazy, but, you know, I play MMOs to chill and relax. I don't play them to, like, be super competitive and do perfect rotations and blah, blah, blah. I don't take it super seriously, so I really just enjoy what I do. I just remember that games are for relaxing, for playing, for escaping from the real world and stuff like that. Okay, let us kill. I'm sure we're almost at the first boss at this point. I keep pressing F out of habit because you press F to do nearly everything in Blade and Soul. have to remember that it's right click in this game. Okay, so again, I've never done this boss, so I have to just react to what I see. Thankfully, I've got 21k health, so I should be okay. Okay, if you get turned into a frog, run outside of the map. Okay. Is that it? Is that the tactic? Cool. Let's do it. Generally, you tank bosses in the middle, so let's assume that's not changed. Let's go to the event tab. And the usual advice in any game, don't stand in the crap. Bubble, I don't know what the bubble means. Oh. Interesting. I'm almost bored, so I'm going to just start hitting random buttons and see what happens. Okay. More bubbles. Frog song. Okay, so the team are killing the frogs. The animation and the graphics is so fluid and so smooth. Like, it really is not this smooth in Blade and Soul. I hope they like fix the optimization in that game. And I also, as well, in case you guys have been curious, like why I've been playing 14 lately, it's just I've got a taste now for playing lots of other games. So let's see if I can just avoid this stuff. Do I still take damage? No, I don't. Cool. I've got a massive taste for other games right now. I've played so many great ones, and lately I've been playing a game called Portal Knights, which I would recommend to anyone, really. It's really, really fun. And, what it's about, like, think Minecraft, but with Zelda combat and modern graphics. This hell is really, really good fun. And I've already played for like 20 hours into it and so on. But generally, yeah, 14 is a good game. You know, the reason I've been bitter towards it is because I wish content would release quicker. That's it. Maybe I'm greedy, maybe whatever, but I've been playing this game now for like 2.5 years. And I was expecting maybe I was dreaming, but I was hoping the level of content that they would release would maintain, and obviously it doesn't anymore. But that's it, that's life. I'm gonna be playing this game forever, so. Okay, I need to heal. Please heal me. I'm dead. Okay, he's casting res on me. Accept. Okay, let us taunt. I'll be honest, I don't even remember what my taunt button is. Ah, yeah, there he is. Well. Ah, there we go. Okay, dead. Sorry, like I said, never played this dungeon before. I'll be honest, I haven't got a clue why I died. So, whatever. Let's move on. Wow. Interesting. I just stood in the AoE bubble. My bad. Sorry, guys. So there's three bosses in here. Are we actually now in the ethereal plane? This is cool. This looks really nice. Okay, Charlie and Mimic. I just wait for the fourth person to get here before I pull. Okay. Let's do it. Spin. I am probably the first person who ever wiped on that boss in the history of this boss. So, only here, guys. YouTube.com/Mithrie. Thank you for the people who have subscribed. Thank you more to the people who have unsubscribed and then resubscribed and so on. And I really want to welcome all you guys from all the other gaming communities that I've been taking part in these days. And for the continued love and support. Like, every hour of every single day, my videos get viewed anything from 200 to 500 times. Every hour of existence. And it's been that way for months. So it's really such a, like, you know, blessing. It's such a compliment, really, to have that level of support in my channel. It really is. It's just, it's crazy. And you know, best hobby I've ever had. Will it one day turn into a job? Who knows? We can dream. But the thing is, the main point for me is that it is a hobby. It is something I do for fun. So I am only trying to play games which I actually do enjoy. If I don't enjoy a game, I just don't play it. Even if I have spent money on it, if I regret my decision of buying the game, I'll return it immediately and play and occupy my time only playing games I really enjoy. Because I want to make sure as well that when you guys watch me here on my YouTube channel, that you just feel like you're taking part in a fun time. That you're not watching me play a game just because I'm obliged to, or that I'm paid to, or whatever, you know. So I'll give you an example. When I was given the opportunity to play early access for Portal Knights, I actually did look at the videos and I thought, wow, this actually looks really fun. I never played a sandbox game, but I saw the video. I was like, yeah, I'll actually try it. It looks fun. I was offered a early access to another game exactly at the same time, and I watched the videos of that and I was like, no, this is really not fun for me. So even if it was early access and, you know, free and blah blah blah, I outright refused to play it. So I'm trying to stick to certain principles on my YouTube channel, that the main goal of everything I do on YouTube is to have fun. All the rest is a bonus. You know, if I make money, I will try and do more giveaways. If I somehow become famous, which I won't, but if I ever do, then I'll just remember always the goal. And I still, even until now, even after 2.5 years, I try to answer every single comment and every single question on my YouTube channel. So you can see on my videos that all the video comments lately have got answers to them. And the only reason why you might find some of them weren't is because I had some issues with my old Google Plus account and I lost the first 100,000 comments I did, which, you know, rip, but whatever. I'm now YouTube verified, so sacrifices had to be made, let's say. And yeah, so if you guys agree or disagree with my concepts or whatever, then please tell me. You know, I like to hear both sides of the story, but I also like it to be constructive. So, you know, if people say to me this is bad or something I'm doing is wrong or whatever, then please, for the love of God, tell me how I can make it good. You know, don't just say this is bad. That's not constructive. That's not useful to me, because I'll just, you know, you and you'll make yourself out to be a flamer. You won't, or a troll. You won't give yourself a positive light. So even if you have a legitimate concern, if you don't offer a solution, then, you know, you're wasting everyone's time. And generally, like I said, you know, not every comment given to me needs an answer, let's say. So what I do in some situation, well, in a lot of situations actually, is that I give it a Google Plus One to show you that I've read your message. So if I've read your message, I give it a Google Plus One, assuming I have nothing to say to it. If I have something to say, I'll give it a Google Plus One and I'll do a reply as well. So the Google Plus One is my way of saying to you, yes, I've read your message. Okay, so sorry guys, I'm completely disoriented from this game. The combat, this 2-second global cooldown, to me, it feels like a lifetime. Like, I'm sure maybe some of you have been playing so many other games as well. You might feel that coming back to 14. It's like, I can't believe it. Like, I wonder, it might, you know, to be honest, it might be why PvP is not so great in this game, because, you know, PvP generally, usually in MMOs, is very hectic, because you're like desperately trying to survive and so on. And in this game, it's like hit 2 seconds, hit 2 seconds, maybe weave in an ability or two. But let's see. If you get tethered, hide behind a rock. Okay, kill the rock adds first and then the others. Go, go, go. Cool. Okay. So thankfully he's very... It's one thing I did always compliment about this game is that the community is very helpful and they're very nice people. Okay, so let's see. Damn it. Okay, so if you hurt them to a certain point, then please, for the love of God, heal me. Anyway, if you hurt them to a certain point, apparently they just stop growing the AoE on the floor. The 65% to gore. Run out of the crap. And by the way, guys, I want your general feedback as well for the people who've been watching me for ages. Like, are you happy that I switched to 60 FPS streaming? Is it a noticeable increase in quality on my channel? Oh God, there's still one alive. Ziggy takes careful aim. Ah, rip. I stood in the way. Damn it. Okay. So he's destroying, obviously, all of these blocks. Let's go Deliverance. Fell Cleave. Double Fell Cleave. I'd have to do it again. Hello? I'm dead. Rip. Except the res. Yep. Again, I'm probably the only person in the world to ever have wiped on this boss, or any boss in this dungeon. Okay, so... let's keep going. So 18% to go. Boom, boom, boom. It's all down to me. No. Die. Oh, come on. We actually not let them kill the healer. Okay. I did not know. He had like probably 4 HP left. Okay, and help them kill the rocks as well. Okay. Okie dokie. Deliverance is still up. Yep, it's still up. You're using an earring that has no stats, warrior. I am. Well, slaying. Why am I wearing this one? Okay, vending. Here we go. Sorry, my bad. Not played for months. Whoops. Anyway, let's do it. So yeah, this is definitely a returning player struggling to remember which way is up, which way is down situation. Okay. Oh, cool. That was easy. Okay, so he's tethered, so he has to hide behind a rock. If Xenosis Vex was here right now, he would be appalled at how I'm representing warriors right now. Okay, let's kill. Time to get the little lads off the healer, as they asked me nicely to do. Hide behind a rock. Hide behind another rock. And a third. Rip. And a fourth? Nope, not a fourth. Okay. Okay, 32% to go. Run away. Yep, good to go. The Defiance up. Let's get these off the healer. So 22% to go.
I can't believe Mithrie died on both bosses in the anti-tower. He must be the worst player ever. I'm so good because I comment.
I'm sorry, that's every troll ever. And 1%. Well, we're done. That was easy. Let's keep going. Okay, let's wait for the fourth person to get in. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm already late. Lol. I was gonna say. Pardon me. That's why I think I'm still Cyclone wearing off, like exactly when I need it. Overpower. Let's make sure they all stay on me. Marvin the Martian's here. And for anyone watching, how many of you are looking forward to the Final Fantasy IX release on Steam? Final Fantasy IX is probably my favourite Final Fantasy game of all of the Final Fantasy games, even more than 7. And I am fully intending to do a full Let's Play of it the second it releases on Steam. I just hope that there's good achievements on the Steam version, and that they do actually at least try to improve the graphics and stuff, at least a little bit. So clear all, where all witness. Okay. Are we going to get Minfilia back after this dungeon? There's a treasure coffer over here. Ha. Huh. Yoink. Oh well. Let's pass. Really not that great at tanking, am I? A lot of people have been telling me how difficult it is to achieve the stats for 3.2 required for 3-star. It is something I'm... You know, what I would recommend, if you're really struggling with it, just do like I do every single time. Make a spreadsheet. Like, you see all the spreadsheets I've made on my in the About section on my YouTube channel for previous tiers of gear. And just plan. Just plan all the stats. Plan what material you would need, what the caps might be. And don't be scared to just go on Reddit, go on thing, and find people who've made guides already. And it's important for when it comes to materia, because you don't want to spend millions of gil on materia that you find out is not even the optimal materia that you need for the items. You know, you want to make sure, like I try and make sure always, that I only have to invest on the materia once per set. And I haven't got a clue just yet if you can have one set for all 8 crafts, or if they really have forced the specialist route. I will try and find all that stuff out with time, but don't wait for me. Like, you know, literally, that's all I'm gonna do is make a spreadsheet and plan it myself. I'm gonna and read guides myself, compile the information. Like, I hopefully at this point, after 2 years, I've taught all of you guys how to be the independent Omnicrafter and to work things out for yourself. That was always my goal with all my guides, is to help you do it yourself. So I wasn't teaching you crafting, I was teaching you self-reliance. I like the style of this dungeon, it's quite pretty. Okay, let's continue. And there's obviously a lot of Final Fantasy content to do for 3.2, so I might actually stream it again tomorrow. But Wednesday I'm going to be playing Blade and Soul, because on Wednesday they're releasing Floor 8 of the Mugen Tower. Come on. Let's steal Cyclone. And I want to do the Hildebrand quests. I miss Hildebrand. There's actually a playlist on my YouTube channel of the entire Hildebrand series. And it does genuinely make me laugh. It's like, especially the way, whenever Hildebrand's dad gets involved, that really makes me laugh. Okay. Let's double seal Cyclone. Pew! I'm gonna actually try and use some cooldowns. Do the healer a favor. And I'm sure as well my gear is really far behind. And the thing is, you know, for me, I have never done, ever, Bismarck Extreme. I've never done Ravana Extreme. I have been slowly, let's say, reducing my gameplay in 14 for a while now, for many months. Just after 2.5 years, you know, you get burnt out. And I didn't, I only got the Vanu Vanu Beast Tribe to like rank 3 or something. I don't know if I'm even going to have time to start the NAF one. But I have to be true to myself as well that, you know, there's a limited appeal to playing one game for me personally, let alone for the viewers. So I want to make sure that I keep having fun. So we are the Calabrina, adorable dolls, terrible dolls, yip ho ho. Huh. Okay. Anyway. If you get Mark turned away, gaze will be on you. If she curls up, only attack her from the front. When we turn into ads, kill swap to break us out. Tank busterish move, forget what it's called. Once you see it, use a cooldown tank. It looks like she's going to jump on you. Okie dokie. Go, go, go. Cool. So I got an achievement for exploring the anti-tower. You know, I don't even know which one I'm supposed to be attacking. Damn it. This is a very weird fight. I'm assuming once we kill the little ones, they're gonna like merge into like a super one or something, right? That would be my guess. Don't quote me on that. I really haven't watched any videos at all. I don't know anything about this dungeon, this fight. Okay. Yeah. Exactly. It's exactly what I said, right? Damn it. My bad. How long am I? Whoops. My bad. Get my mouse over the... Oh, I see. So they get sent to like a rip. Get sent to like an ethereal zone, ethereal plane. Well, rip. Okay. Oh, okay, I got turned into an ad. I'm so dead. Is anyone watching? Tell me 10 things I'm doing wrong. Okay, I'm a doll again. Eureka. Aggressive much. Okay. Is that? I keep forgetting that I'm not a paladin, so I don't have like big cooldowns anymore. I'm just a meat shield. I just survive with like massive health. Turned again. I am the red ad. Cool. Well, I got totally carried. So, let's list 10 problems with that. 1. No face cam, no aggro, no deliverance, no fending, no buffing for busters. I didn't DPS the ads. I have low self-healing, I'm not berserking, I'm not maiming, and I generally suck. There you go. 10 things I did wrong in that fight. But we killed it, so who cares? Yeah, let's pass that. Give it to the healer, because he had to raise me like 7 times. Okay, so thank you very much. So, you know what, I can just press my flipping button. Goodbye. Okay, let's get rid of that. Exit. Let's see if there's any cutscene after this dungeon. Hi, Dalian. Hi. Well, her voice is getting clearer.
We are the word of the mother. We, who were once called Minfilia.
Is she dead?
Much time hath passed for thee since the bloody banquet. Since I hearkened to her word. Mother, Hydaelyn guided me towards Ishtola and Thancred, that I might be swept up in their flow and delivered unto the ethereal sea. There, adrift and alone, her voice silent once more, I prayed for those we had lost, for those we can yet save. To her I would make an offering.
Okay, that wasn't creepy.
One voice. One will. One word. Unto thee we bequeath the most precious of gifts, the truth which lieth at the heart of this world. Thus do we beseech thee once more. Hear. Feel. Think. Before there was life in the depths of the ethereal sea, light and dark did once dwell as one. But the darkness coveted power, and the balance was broken. Thus was I forced to banish him unto the distant heavens, to forever remain apart, a moon bound. In sundering the star did we cry out, and the barriers twixt planes chanced to falter. Across 10 and 3 were we then divided, reflections of the source, each possessed of a shard. Zodiac longeth to be made whole. For his restoration, for his resurrection, his servants labor without cease. They seek to tear down the barriers which surround the source. Thus do they rejoice in their ardor, in your calamities. For each marks a rejoining. Seven times have they succeeded. Seven times hath the darkness grown stronger. Seven times have I failed. The Asians cannot be suffered to continue. This is my final. Is all but spent. With what remains,
I will return you to the shore of the Ethereal Sea. Blessed children, go forth and seek. Seek.
RIP.
Thank the 12. Did you find her? Did you find Minfilia?
Yeah, I apologize guys if the voice is really, really quiet compared to the music. There's not really anything I can do about it.
Nor am I. Cryo? As unbelievable as it sounds, I see no reason to doubt her. The word's tale. No one was more sensitive to the will of Hydaelyn than Minfilia. And if Hydaelyn has grown so weak that she can barely make herself heard, it is not hard to see why Minfilia, having joined with her, might struggle to maintain her own form.
Why would she need to maintain her own form? Are you saying she's gone? But that cannot be! Not now. Not after all we have accomplished. We were meant to usher in the dawn's light together.
She threw herself on the fire to fuel your dawn's light, boy. You'll just have to usher it in on your own.
Must you be so ungentle?
Tell me about the Scions, boy.
That the Scions of the Seventh Dawn lay before Eorzea's salvation. Whenever the realm is threatened, be it by Primal, Ascian, Garlean, or any other, we take up arms in her defense, that all in Eorzea may live to see a brighter tomorrow.
And that's very noble of you. But in chasing after these lofty goals of yours, you seem to have lost sight of some basic truths. To win a war, you must be willing to do whatever it takes. To fight, to kill, and if necessary, to die. The path you've chosen is paved with the dead. Walk it with your eyes open, or not at all.
I know the truth of which you speak. And have from the first. If the Ascians will go to any length to resurrect their god, then we must needs be as committed to our cause, to unmask them and their schemes, and to crush them both utterly. Come, there is much to be done.
Yes, of course.
Thancred, wait! No. No, this is all wrong.
Okay. Rip Memphilia. That was kind of weird. Let's finish off the quest. So she's not coming back, is she? She did what she thought was best. Dot dot dot. It weighs on you too, I know. I understand why she made her decision. And yet, every time we lose another friend, I have to ask myself if there was not another way. Okay. So, yeah, thanks Minfilia, you've been good to be around since the game started, but whatever, you're now gone. Oh, I got an orchestra and wall, where didn't I get that? Well, anyway, so we're going to leave the episode there, hope you enjoyed it, and like I said, it is a story-based game, it is pretty epic, so make sure you haven't skipped these cutscenes, only finished dungeons for the first time, because you could be missing out on some severe plot twists and spoilers, so like really make sure you take part in all of it. So anyway guys, that's it for this episode, thank you for watching, and as always, goodbye from me, and goodbye from Mithrie.